Hi everyone, in this video let's talk about iterator design pattern, which is another pattern and we use it rarely, but in few cases we use it. So iterator design pattern means we have iterable object, a kind of collection, and we need to iterate. So in the iteration, like you are getting the first index, last index, rewind, you're getting the next index. So it is like you are trying to iterate on an array or an iterable object. Okay, so let me write some example on this, then we'll talk about it. I have a keyboard issue with this function label. Sorry. Okay, so I will initialize because I'm trying to write few methods which will help me on iterating the data. So my data is looking something like this. Okay, this is nothing but an array. Okay, and I have length variable which is nothing but data.length. Okay, here what I will do is returning some helper methods which will help us to iterate onto this particular array. Okay, iterator pattern means it is helping you to iterate on elements. Okay, so when you call next, what it will give you, it should be able to give you the next element. Consider this is the element. Okay, so we need to have one method which can check if do we have the next element available. This dot has next. If next element is there, then what we need to do, if next element is not there, then return null. Okay. Otherwise, what we need to do is we need to return the index value. Element equal to data, and we already have the index, and increase the index with 1. This is what we need to do. And just return the element. Okay, this is the element which we are returning. Now we are using hasNext utility method here. So let's see what hasNext will do. hasNext will check if you have the next element in the array or not. So in the hasNext, it is just checking if the current index return, if index is less than the length, because we are tracking the index every time whenever we are doing the next. So index is increasing one by one. Similarly, rewind is another function, and what we are doing, we are resetting the index. So index equal to 0, and what we are returning is data.index. I mean, we are just returning the 0th value of that array, and the current means we wanted to get the current value wherever you are, right? So it will return data of index. Similarly, you can write the other utility method is delete index. And what it will do, you just pass the index and it will delete data of index. And because it will set the undefined. So whenever you delete the index from the array, it will set the value of that is undefined. So we can do wait a second, delete of index, it is giving error. really very sorry, deleting the data index, and data of that index we need to set that to 0 or null, because whenever you delete something from the array, it's set to undefined. So these are the utility, right? It's kind of iterator function I created. Now iterator dot next, dot hasNext, dot rewind, all these methods I can call.